It's time for this week's Highlander Highlights. In men's basketball, it was a week of dramatic victories for the Highlanders. Carly Jones banked in a game-tying three-pointer as time expired in regulation to force overtime before draining a game-winning three-ball with 1.8 seconds left in the extra session, lifting Radford to a 101-98 victory at Hampton on Thursday night. A native of nearby Portsmouth, Travis Fields Jr. had the best game of his career with 33 points on 12 of 14 shooting, including 6 three-pointers, and he also added 7 rebounds and 6 assists. He became the first Highlander to score 30 or more points in a game since Cam Jones, who scored 35 in 2016. Senior forward Ed Polite Jr. added his 11th double-double of the season with 14 points and 12 rebounds. Then on Saturday afternoon, the battle-tested Highlanders made winning plays when it mattered the most to come away with a 69-66 victory over High Point in overtime at the Dedman Center. Radford went 5-6 from the free throw line in the extra period to help seal another nail-biting victory. The Highlanders improved to 18-7 overall and 10-1 in the Big South, keeping them atop the Big South standings. Carleek Jones stuffed the stat sheet with 14 points, 5 rebounds, and 5 assists, and junior Donald Hicks added 18 points on 5 of 10 shooting, including 4 made 3-balls. And senior forward Ed Polite Jr. pulled down a career-high tying 19 rebounds. The Highlanders hit the road once again, this time for a rematch with Charleston Southern on Saturday the 16th, following a full week off. The game is slated for a 5:30 p.m. tip-off at the Buck Dome. In women's basketball, 3 Highlanders recorded double-doubles as Radford defeated Gardner-Webb 79-69 on Tuesday evening at the Dedman Center. Senior guard Destiny Walker scored a game-high 19 points while also grabbing 11 rebounds, and redshirt junior forward Lydia Rivers scored her 600th point and picked up her league-leading 9th double-double with 14 points and a game-high 15 boards. Then on Saturday, the Highlanders remain in first place in the Big South after picking up a thrilling 84-79 double overtime victory at High Point. The win was the 8th straight for the Highlanders, who handed the hosts their first home defeat of the season. Radford improved to 16-6 overall and 10-1 in the league, which is their best conference start since the 91-92 campaign. 3 Highlanders produced double-doubles for the 2nd straight contest, as Lydia Rivers led the way, matching a season high with 17 points and equaling her career best 16 rebounds. It was her league-leading 10th double-double of the season. Junior guard Kiana Johnson added 6 assists and 16 points and picked up her 800th career point. The Highlanders look to keep it rolling on Saturday when they play host to Longwood at 2 p.m. And in women's track and field, another school record fell, as did several personal records, as the Highlanders took part in the 2nd and final day of the 2019 VMI Winter Relay. Running in the 4x400-meter relay, Kara Foster, Letitia Chambers, Ryan Payne, and Chansey Gunnell broke the Radford indoor school record with a time of 3.52 and 55 tenths seconds. The quartet's time toppled the previous record, which was set back on February 25, 2006. It was also the 2nd fastest time for the 4x4 in the Big South this season. In the weight throw, freshman Mary Brown earned a huge PR with a distance of 12.94 meters to finish in the top half of the field. A pair of Highlanders, Letitia Chambers and Denisha Hoosier, had good times in the 200-meter dash. Chambers ran a 25.04, which ranks 8th on the Radford all-time list to place 3rd out of 50 competitors, while Hoosier earned a new PR of 25.82 seconds. The Highlanders get set for the meet they've been working towards all winter long, the 2019 Big South Indoor Championships. Radford will have the chance to compete against the best in the conference on Friday, February 15th and Saturday the 16th at the Liberty Indoor Track and Field Complex. And that's a look at this week's Highlander Highlights. For RadfordAthletics.com, I'm Rick Watson.